Greetings and salutations, my friends. Welcome to a brand new series on my channel. This is the brand new Motorsport Manager. It's basically Football Manager in cars, without the goals and shit, you know, stuff like that. We're going to be doing a series on this. It's going to be lots of fun. It's going to run alongside my Football Manager, so don't panic. There'll still be tons of Football Manager, but I've really wanted to play this for ages. I was a big Formula One fan back in the day. Not so much in the last sort of 5-6 years, just because it's become so dull. Unless it's raining, it's just dull. But hopefully this is a bit more exciting. I've played about half a season just to sort of learn the basic ropes so I can show you guys. What I'll do, even if you have no knowledge of what's going on, I'm just going to show you through the basics and everything like that so you can get an idea of what's going on. So we're creating our driver, Loki Doki. We're from the United Kingdom. You can choose your backstory. So I can be an ex-driver, which gives morale to the drivers, which is nice. I can be an ex-engineer, part design time minus 1 day. It's quite nice. Financial, everything's a bit cheaper. Political, I don't know what it's called. Political. Voting power plus 4 because we vote on rules for the next season. Or unknown, just a man of mystery. I quite like the man of mystery. We're going to go for the ex-driver, right? You know, I don't even have a driving license, so that doesn't really help. But yeah, ex-driver, great. Right, so first off, you've got three different series. We've got the world, they don't have the licenses for Formula 1, but this World Motorsport is Formula 1. Then you've got the Asia Cup, and then you've got European racing. I think we go in at the bottom. We don't want to go in as the big boys. There's various parts and stuff. We'll show you that as we go through. 10 events in 6 locations. Prize fund of 125 million. There's a lot of money pissing about in this game. It's ridiculous. If you've watched my Journeyman football series, you know I don't even get paid. So when I'm paying hundreds of millions of pounds, it's quite ridiculous. So these are the teams in there which we can take over. I think that shittest team is Predator. Much like when you're looking at staff on a Football Manager, you can see that this is the these bars here show you how good you are at the various things. How good is our car? If the line was right at the top, that's the best in the championship. So we are the worst at everything in the championship. We're expected to finish last. There's no pressure. There's no budget. We're an Australian team, brand new. It's quite tempting that I want to go lower end. I don't want to go like with a big team. Then we've got ZRT Motorsport. So as you can see, the difference here, quite double the budget, finished 9th, still low expectation. But they've got decent drivers. Excuse me. And they've got decent sponsors, so a bit more money coming in. I'm not sure I like the blue. We can change that a little bit as well. We've got Archer BMR. This is what I did in my previous like private save just to get used to the game, so I'm not going to choose them. And then we've got Dragon, Race Team China. Right, not racist. They look like a pretty decent team. I'm tempted to start with Predator. Is that really a bad idea? Is that because they are literally the shittest everything. Predator may be a young team, but that what they lack in experience, they make up for in pluck. How many grid positions do you get in for pluck? A shoestring budget forces everyone to muck in and has gradually nurtured a fantastic team rapport. A small team with great... Let's do it. We're going to start from the bottom up. Don't expect us to get any podiums at this point, people. Don't expect us to get many points. It's all about survival, building up a bit of money so we can then improve the club, I was going to say, but the team. We can build parts, we can build headquarters and training facilities and practice tracks and all that sort of stuff. But I'll take you through it as we go. I'll do a brief overview when we get to the main game just so I can show you each screen, show you all about it, etc, etc. I'm no expert, by the way, in this. Like I said, I played a season, I've learned all the basics, so I know what I'm looking at, but still doing it. So we've got, here's our two drivers, we'll take you through the screen. So our balance is 250 million, income per race, we're making a bit of income. There's a lot, like I said, there's a lot of money flowing about in here. You've got the predicted forecast for the next race and stuff, what's important. So top speed for the next race, acceleration and high speed corners is important. And there's some track info there that we ignore because that's not important, is it? And then we've got our mailbox there. So we'll go in from the start. So this is our home screen, just gives us a basic overview. Chairman's happiness, we've just joined, so they hadn't given us a objective. I'm hoping it would just become last, please, because otherwise... So this is me as a person, race management and financial. These change over to part time depending on what you do, my history, all that stuff. And we'll show you the mail afterwards. This is our lovely car. So with the car, throughout the season, you design new parts for the car, so it improves over time. okay? So with this series that we're in, this lowest series, we don't have any control over the front wing or the rear wing. So they're default standard for everyone, so we don't have to worry about that. So we've just got the engine, the brakes, the gearbox, and the suspension is what we can improve upon. What we do is we design new parts for the thing, we build a new part, only takes very quickly, and then you go on to fit parts onto the various different cars, and you can also improve them, reliability and stuff like this. So we'll go through all that once we've done our bits and bobs. So this is the headquarters. We're in a field somewhere. It's lovely. There's a farmer out there. Look, we've got a factory, one of four, which allows us to build shit. We've got a design center, which allows us to design shit. It's the most basic factory start you can have, really. There's all sorts of new buildings that a lot of them are locked to begin with because you need certain stuff of other things, like a forecasting center for weather. Scouting facility allows you to scout better drivers and stuff like that, and a staff center and all that good stuff there. But this all costs millions, so there's no chance of us doing that anytime soon. We can upgrade buildings as well, so we can ignore that pretty much for the entire season. Next up, we've got the team information about the team. There's me, the team principal. We've got drivers here. We've got Santa Ana, so she's a female driver, 23 years old, looks quite good. So she's currently, like Football Manager, 2 and a bit star, but she can improve. And same with our 27 year old backup driver, he's almost 1 star, but he can improve a little bit there. And we've got a reserve driver, which is good. Lead designer is not great, but she's young, so she could really improve. Same as our race mechanics, actually. So I quite like the fact that we've got no oldies. They're all nice and young, apart from me. So they can all improve a lot. So that's really, really nice to see. And there's the team stats. These are our drivers, as you see in a bit more detail. So this is our star person. They're our main driver. And we've got a backup driver. We've got 2 women as our drivers as well. You know, I'm not sexist like that. This is their stats, attributes, braking, cornering, smoothness, overtaking, consistency, adaptability, fitness, feedback, and focus. All relatively simple. She gets paid £167,000 per race. Yeah, I know. It's fucking crazy. And then you look at your staff. So each driver is assigned a race mechanic. And as they work together for longer, they unlock special abilities like higher engine modes, no longer impact condition. All of this will become clear when we actually get into race day, because I'll explain it again. So basically, you want a race mechanic to work with the driver for a long period of time so they get friendly-ish. Then you've got your scouting, so you can find new drivers, designers, and race mechanics. Finances, we can see what we're earning. Sponsors, we get new sponsors, give us a load of cash, depending on where we finish in races and stuff like that. Standings in the table, and a cheeky calendar. Right, so that's the sort of basics, but if you're confused, it'll all become clear very, very quickly. Welcome to Predator Racing Group. I'm Tommy, and I'll keep you up to date with everything going on around the team. Thank you. Right, so this is our main best driver here. I used to be a fan of yours back when you were racing. Thanks. She's hitting on me already, so it's to be expected. Really looking forward to seeing what you can bring to the team this season. I get on really well with William Evans, so I'm hoping to keep us all feeling like one big family. That's nice to see. Okay, this is the other driver man, is it? Yeah, I grew up watching you racing. Look, they're just lying now. Santa Ana and I get on okay, but I'm going to be working my socks off to prove that I'm a much better driver. Okay, I like it. I don't mind a bit of oomph in the team, fighting each other. Not just don't fall out, right? Then we've got our lead designer. You were one hell of a driver back in the day. If you were anywhere near that good as a boss, then we're in for a good season. On the HU front, blah, blah, blah. On the car front, we could definitely use some work on the suspension. It's lagging behind the competition. We could do with an upgrade. Okay, it's good to know. We've got the scout telling us what position. So our 2 drivers are expected to finish bottom and second from bottom this season. So, good. So this is our targets. It's the start of the new season, so we need to clarify just how well you think the team is going to do this. Not very well, mate. Not very well. Which sets the pyramid, sets the payment amount pyramid. What the fuck is the pyramid cover for? That I give you after each race. Now, I know that we don't have the greatest team in the championship, but I can offer you a little more cash if you think that we can avoid coming last. I'm going to say last. I don't see how we're not going to come last. So I'm going to go with that. It's not a massive win. It's 1.84 as a 300 grand a race more. No, not worth the risk, because I could risk losing my job. So we'll have a look at the car now. So we're going to design a new part. So as we said, the front wing and the rear wing, can't touch it. All season long, don't touch it. So what did she say? Suspension. I think she said suspension, didn't it? If you actually look what we've got at the moment, so this little red yellow bar is what we're using, and then what we can make if we create a new part. So let's just make one. It's a lot easier to go through. Well, I'm all for a gearbox. I think that yellow bar there is like reliability, and red is when it starts breaking, so that's the lowest. The suspension actually isn't all right. It's pretty reliable, so I'm gonna go. Oh, we can't even afford it. It's £1 million to start this, and we've got 250k. So we're going to have to earn some money before we can upgrade anything. Man, this is going to be a tricky season. So we'll move on from that. Yeah, let's hit continue. So it's pretty simple. Even if you're not a fan of motorsport, once you get into this, I've played this, like I said, played the season. Really, really enjoying it so far. It's a really nice, clever game. Okay, I'm the new boss. Somebody's retiring. Okay, mixed reaction to me again. So it's fine, it's fine. Congratulations on joining. Are you interested in doing an interview? Yeah, go on then. Well, you certainly picked a tough task for your first job. I expected to pick up many points this season. No. Yeah, I'm going to say... I'll say I'm quietly confident we'll manage a few decent finishes. Because that decent finish to me could be like second to last. Ines Santa Ana has been seen by the fans as your top driver. Do you agree with that? Or will you say that William Evans is better? I'm just going to say they're two great drivers so I don't piss off anyone. I wrote that you're expected to finish 10th. Is that accurate? Do you think you can do any better? Yeah, we're going to finish 10th. I'm pretty sure of that. We all remember your time as a fan favourite racer a few years ago, but will you be able to transfer your skills? Yeah. I'm sure it'll be fine. Everybody seems happy with that. So we're literally going to have to save up money to improve our first part, which is going to be interesting. What we'll do in this first episode is take you through the basics of everything, but then each like corresponding episode we'll do less of the techie stuff, and I'll just give you an update on what's happened, but I'll just take you through the race on the day sort of thing. You know, the fun, the exciting bit. We can't improve anything, so we're never going to be able to fast efficient gear change if we don't invest into... I haven't got 5 million, love. I've got 250 grand. She's somebody's out clubbing. Is that our woman? We're Predator. Is that our woman? What's her name? Katie Lunaris. Yeah, I don't care if somebody else is out getting pissed. That's fine. Right. Huge anticipation. Everybody's loving it. Right, so now we get to choose our sponsors for the season. So we've got one sponsor already. And... basically, he says if we can finish 16th or above, he'll give us 200 grand. Okay? What we've got to look at is stuff that where we get an upfront payment, because we need money up front. We're not going to finish well. Like target position, second or above. It's never going to happen. It's never going to happen. So, but we'll have that 100 grand. And this will last for 4 races. So we'll take that 100 grand in the bank. Thank you very much. And so like this one, for instance, 9th or above, and they're going to give us 750 grand up front. That allows us to build our first part, which is going to be huge. There are race bonus sponsors. Then we have fixed payment sponsors. You can have it per race day, or you can have upfront payments. We want upfront. Simple as that. It's for 4 races. It's 450 grand. We want to get some money in the door. This should allow us to build one good part. No other offers. That's fucking harsh. Right, so we can now go to car, and I'll show you the process of designing a new part. So I'm thinking gearbox was my... It's expensive, isn't it? Okay, we'll go for brakes, because they're 500,000. When you design a new part, it's only one thing. It's not like, oh, we've got 100 of these now. It's one part. So we can make average parts. So we could get to choose one of these 4 options to add to the part to make it better. So we can have... better deceleration, which is good. Minus 5 red zone, which is good. That means if you click on it there, less likely to break down. But a risk level of plus 1, meaning you're actually breaking the rules slightly, and you can actually get fined and relegated places on the grid position. So it's a little bit of risk reward on that one. Next up, we've got the red zone minus 10, so just a little bit more reliable. We've got deceleration 25 plus another 15 plus risk 1. I don't know if it's going to be risky or not. I'm going to go this one. I think I'm going to go this one. Gives us better deceleration, red zone minus 5%. So a little bit more reliable and a little bit better, right? So that's they cost 50 grand to add one of those. At the moment, we can only add one. So now we're going to build the part. It's going to cost 500,000. Ow, ow, ow. But it allows us to build that part and then build another part on top of that, so which is really good. Next, we get to fit parts, but at the moment, we've got standard parts, so we don't have to worry about that too much. Then we can improve the parts, where we look at all the parts we've got there. We've got two our main race mechanics here that will work on these parts. So we can say to them, I want you to... This is the performance. So let's look at the top one, for instance. So 1, 22. So 1 is the current performance. If we keep working on this to make this part better, we can get up to a total of 22 maximum. Okay, that's how that works. So I think we should make this the engines better. Let's make the engines better and also more reliable. The reliability is only 58 and 60%, so we'll work on that as well. So just have better engines, and then we'll leave that till last when we actually build new parts. So we can then change this up to how long stuff will take, what's more important. I think reliability is more important now, so we're going to full work on reliabilities. It's going to take us 36 days after the race. They're not great. Is this going to be better? 91, 36. You can swap them around. Actually, it is better, because each of these guys has stats. So, okay, right, we're working on it. So now we've got the race day. So you only choose one of those three sponsors. So there's no point in picking second place or above. It's not going to happen. So we'll pick 16th or above. It'll give us 200 grand bonus, right? So then this is our track. They're saying top speed is crucial, acceleration is crucial, and high speed corners crucial. So there's the track. Tire wear is very high. It looks like we're going to have nice weather. So this is the practice. We're about to have the practice day. I'll show you one practice day, but after that we'll skip ahead. Otherwise, these videos would be way too long. So if we're going to fit the parts, which we don't have any of, so I'm worried about these gearboxes because their reliability is awful. Same with the brakes, which means extra pit stops and stuff, which take ages. It's not going to be pretty. So we don't need to fit parts because there's nothing left. That's it. That's kind of sad. Right, I didn't even see what country we're going at. Where are we going? Where is that? This is the Black Sea in Russia. For more than Russia. Right, boys, here we go. So, don't expect too much. Anything above last position is good, okay? We want to just make a little bit of money slowly over time and build our team up. I think we've got good sort of potential drivers. So, hopefully... they can be happy. There's a nice little track, cheeky little track there. So, on to the practice sessions. So, each driver has a feedback setting. And this is when you do the setup for the race, they'll tell you if it's good or not and what needs changing. So, the higher the setup, the more information they give you. So, for instance, as it stands now, my top driver's 8, that's okay. He gives no feedback whatsoever, so you can send out your reserve driver to get the feedback for the race, which is, I think, what we'll do. So then we'll change the setup. This is the bit that's a bit foggy for me, because I'm no expert at all this shit. But it doesn't take very long once you get used to it. And you can actually, like, instant do it as well, so you don't have to go through all this if you want to. So the little yellow signposting thing is where what your current settings are. Your mechanics recommendation is somewhere in this green bit, and as you get more feedback, that green bit shrinks down and you can get a better idea. You can do a couple of practice sessions. So we're right at the bottom of this speed, so we can increase the gear, lengthen, I think is the correct wordage there, speed balance, and we'll have a little bit more downforce. You kind of have to just guess, really. Unless you know shit about this stuff, then you're probably not guessing. But I'm pretty much guessing. I know what they can't do, but whether or not, you know, I'm doing the right stuff. So this is practice. We're going to send them out on the super soft tiles. Actually, we're going to send them out on the soft. I like softies. You know, softies. And then same again for this. Slightly different because each driver drives differently. So we know that it looks like they're wanting more downforce. So that's good. So we can use that to our advantage. We want more acceleration and a bit more understeer. There we go. You can go out on the softies. When you're doing this practice sessions, if you're driving around in soft, you get like bonus knowledge, like soft tires, which will give you bonus knowledge for the race. So try and use the stuff that you're going to use in the race, and then you'll be slightly better. I'm actually, yeah, so this person's acceleration says like halfway and up. It's somewhere in halfway and up, right? And then the other person, halfway and down. So I'm thinking it might be halfway. I'm going to, because they're usually relatively close to each other. We'll try that. Okay, so we can see it. Right, go. So you can do instant results and stuff, so if you don't want to take the time to do it. And I won't show it in the next videos. I'll just let you know how I've got on so we can sort of skip ahead of the boring parts. But I find it interesting, but that's just because I'm weird. Okay, so we've got the setup as we chose. We're going to send them out 3 laps on the soft tyres. We send them out. We've got 12 minutes to do shit. And they're hopefully going to give us some good feedback. So we're going to same with you. Right. So this is the main race screen. So you can click on the person, bottom left and bottom right, to jump between the drivers if you want to watch them. You then have, shows you the position. I just want to point on screen, it's not pointing. That's why I put me there, by the way, because I thought this was a bit out the way a bit. I'm out the way of everything there. So you can see where your position you're in. And then the big one here is strategy. So you start off with medium. What you can say to the driver is, I want you to push a little bit more, but they will wear out their tyres faster. You can also tell them to up the engine mode, meaning that they'll burn more fuel. But obviously your fuel is going to run out quicker. So all very dependent. So as you can see, I've got fuel for 4 laps here. My tyres are at 93%. This little green, blue, red thing is there, the temperature gauge. You don't want them to get too cool, the tyres, or too hot. Otherwise, you'll start losing. You get degradation. I believe it's called degradation. So as we can see, she's I'm going to get used to this. She has started her first lap. It's probably going to be slowest. This is the rest of the field and what tyres they're on. Okay, so look, first feedback. Feels like I've just got the right aero balance. Nice one. So we know we've nailed the aero dynamics of it. This aero setup is fantastic. Right, we fucking nailed that one. Brilliant. Important information together. As we can see as they go around the track, we're building up our knowledge of soft tyres and race trim. Race trim just goes up all the time because you're doing this. It gives you a little bonus in the race, always handy to have. It's horrible when you do, like, you're working on soft tyres and then it pisses down the entire race. So, right, she's completed her first lap. And we'll bring her straight in so we can make some changes. I'm not pushing them, there's no point. We don't need to push these guys. Right, and we'll bring you in as well after you'll finish your lap. So we came 4th and 8th, but we're going to drop down as this is just practice, so there's all sorts of weird timings and shit. So don't get too excited that we're now sitting in 5th. 6th. The handling is spot on. Have I just fucking nailed this first time out? Which would be a first time for everything. Next to the name there, Santa Ana, in the bottom left, you can see that there's a little white, 3 little squares, and that's sector times. A white square means it's not your quickest. A purple square means it's the best of the entire field of all the drivers. A green means it's your personal best in this race. So she had a pretty, it obviously is an in lap, so it didn't really matter. So like Tang above there has just had a world at his best lap. So here's our feedback. You just click send out again and it will give you a more detailed breakdown. So great downforce, good handling and good top speed. I'm happy with that. What I want to know is, does that top speed need to go which way? That's because the feedback is not that good that they give us. It didn't really move much. So do we want more oversteer or less understeer? So there's a bit of guesswork in there, but you use both drivers to try and work it out. And you can always go back one. Like, I can do a different test now, and if it gets worse, I can say use the setup previously. But actually, that is not a bad start to a setup. I'm just not sure if the speed balance needs to go nearer the middle. I just feel like it, because the other driver was like, yeah, I want the speed balance here. I'm going to try it. I'm going to gamble a little bit. And then I've got no idea which way this handling is supposed to go. That way. And it does change other things as well. So obviously you saw the speed balance going up there. Let's try that. We can send her out on the same tyres because she's not done much of them anyway. We'll get a better idea when the second place person comes in. Linaris. Right. Excellent speed balance. Excellent. That's as good as, I think that's as good as you can get. Which is means it was right near the middle because, yeah, look, I've got it right near the middle here. I'm just confused. This confuses me. This does. I think it just takes practice more than anything, to be honest. Bit there. We'll give them some more downforce, but then we'll the gear ratio just to get it back to where it was because we want to keep the speed balance exactly where it is. We could do tyre pressure as well and camber, but we don't want to mess about with that too much. I'm going to put everything-ish near the middle. It's like a weird puzzle game where you're trying to keep shit the same but move other shit. That's pretty damn close to where it was before. Right, go. Hopefully we'll get some decent feedback. As you can see, 18th and 19th. That's more realistic. Right, go on, Santana. Let's just see if we can give her a pacey lap, see how well she can do. So we're going to tell her to push the tyres, push the fuel. And we've got you're always fueled for a couple of laps, so just keep an eye on it. But we can do an out lap, a fast lap, and then an in lap. Not a problem. Right. I want to see a good lap from you, girl. Just coming around for her flying lap, so you can see we're 18th. So that's our colour. So she's just on the coming onto the back straight now. There's the finish line there, start finish. Her best lap was 127.9, so if we can do any better than that, that'd be quite nice. It doesn't really matter too much because you get stuck behind cars in practice and all sorts of weird shit happens, so great camera angle. Handling is feeling superb here, nice guy. Yes, yes. I think we've nailed this practice pretty well. You didn't get too much time, you can only do a couple of sessions, so as you can see, the setup knowledge, she's only just about to hit, like, not shit. Look, there you go, so she's got a fastest first sector of the practice session for her, which is very good. I'm going to see if she can beat that 127.9, it'd be lovely. We'll send them both out a quick lap. Second sector fastest as well. We've got a nice clear track ahead. There's two cars up there. We probably won't catch them unless they're piddling about. Those tweaks to the downforce were great. Nice job with the setup. We've nailed. This is probably my best ever. Sometimes it just completely confuses me. 127.5, so almost half a second quicker than the previous lap, which is great. But don't look at the times too much. This is more about getting your setup right. Whatever you did to the speed balance is working, this is much better. It looks like I'm an expert or something. That was blind luck, most of that. You can start to work out how you should set up the cars based on just experience of doing it a few times, but also looking at the track. Tons of straights, you know, or is it really loads of corners, etc., etc., and adjust for there. But, yeah, I'm not there yet. Right. Need you to bring in as well. She got a best lap as well, just half a second behind the other girl. Oh no, two seconds. Like I said, times don't matter. It's just for fun. Great, good, and excellent. That's not fine. I'll take great, good. So you'll see that the green bits move down now. Look. Ooh. Do we put more wing on it? Or do we put more downforce? We go a little bit more. Should we gamble? But then we want to keep that the same, and we want that to be the same. Wow, that's remarkable. Actually nailed that. Send them out on the same tyres again. Trying to save money here, people. We've only got a small budget. I don't know if they cost money per race, but I don't want to use it. I can feel the handling is much better now. Lovely. Good feedback. Where are you? Are we coming into the pits yet? There she comes. Here she comes. Oh, my Lord. Look at that. Look at it. Two excellence. As we can see, our knowledge levels now have gone up. So race trim and soft tyres, we get a bit more knowledge. I'm not touching that. You can stay in there, love. We can speed up time if you just want to whiz past stuff. We're just going to let her do her last lappy thing. I don't know if she'll get time. We've only got a minute left to do our flying lap. Like, really push it. Go on, push it. She's running out of tyres at this point, but that's fine. She's got to get used to going on one bad tyres. Each of your drivers has, like, various different... As well as having... Oh, I just didn't get to do a flying lap. As well as having various different attributes and stuff to how good they are, they'll also have lots of weird stuff. Like, I was looking last night, I was looking for, on my other save, I was looking for a driver, and I found this really good young girl. She was a wonder kid, but she said ugly was one of her character traits, and it said like minus 30 marketability, because obviously more sponsors are going to come in if you're attractive. We're fucked then. Look at this. The downforce is feeling a bit off. I did go the wrong way. Okay, that's fine. We can just jump it back to the other one. Alright, so we're just waiting for the last few cars to finish. I apologise. This first one's going to be a long video, but the rest won't be nowhere near as long. Once we've done all the explaining and the boring bit in this video, next episode will be a lot quicker. We're going to whiz through, do the races, you know, get to the exciting parts of it and stuff. But I just wanted to sort of show you guys, especially if you're thinking about getting it. So we get like a bit of Twitter shit that's just like a bit of fluff and news about practice, but it doesn't really matter. Right, so we know that Santana's wing was, I went the wrong way, so we need to fix that before we start. Right, so the first thing you do is you look at the weather. It's 11 degrees, it's cloudy, that doesn't look to be in the rain. We can only see like four laps or five laps in advance, the laps along the bottom there, because of... Is it, let me show you, is it? That way, over there. We can only see a few laps in advance. We need a better weather centre to be able to see. But it looks like it's going to be dry. That it looks like there's a little bit of moisture gaining later on, so it might rain later on, around lap 6, 8-ish. We'll keep an eye on it. So these are our practice knowledge. So because we did the soft tyres, we got level 1 of that, and the race trim, we get increased performance. So this is from our, what's it called? The race mechanic, you get bonuses. Higher engine modes no longer impact... That's quite important, actually, because our engines are a bit iffy, I think's the word. So we'll get rid of that and we'll go for that. We'll keep that race trim because 5 plus performance increase everywhere. Whereas soft tyres is just for soft tyres, I think. I think that's how, that makes logical sense. Okay, so our main driver, William Evans, or our second driver, William Evans. I don't think we've got a good enough relationship to select that yet, so we'll have that. What is it? The green sweet spot in qualifying is bigger, giving the driver a better chance of optimising their brake and tyre. Okay. Right, so there's this done. So this is the tyre setup. So we know, we can look at the two and go, okay, this probably needs to be a bit more nearer the middle because she's delighted with it there. And this one we bodged, didn't we? Yeah, so we'll use this setup and then we will gamble a little bit and just move this towards the middle. Is that where we want to go? Yeah, no, that's good. I'm there, right? Maybe even a little bit more, because I think it was the other way we bodged up. So now this is the big one. It's like, it's a 30 lap race. So we know that we've got 30 laps to do. We can fuel for 12 laps. So we know we're going to need to pit stop twice at least. So there's various different methods you can go out on. Obviously, intermediate tyres are for when it's wet. Wets are for when it's absolutely pissing down. Don't use wets too early. I learned that the hard way because it was like raining. I was like, oh, wets. And I was like, no. So we could go out on, say, the super soft tyres, which has got great speed, but they're going to wear out really quick, and go for a really quick first few laps and just, like, destroy it. I think because our reliability on both these cars, especially with the engine, is pretty bad, I don't think we need to push it. I think we just need to have nice, steady races where we chug along, probably near the back, and hope other cars crash and fall out of the race and do that. So I think we're going to go for a soft tyre that will give us 12 laps. So let's say if we did 10 laps, that will two stops, soft tyres every time. I think that will be the least risky option to go with. So we'll take one less lap of fuel because we're only going to do about 10 laps. Loki, shush. Also, like, the amount of fuel you've got in the car makes your car heavier and therefore slower. So, you know, a little bit less fuel might give us a better chance. I think I'm going to go the same with both. Your car setup, I'm going to do this as well. I think it's this way, so I'm going to go and then go that to swap that back. And then like that. And tyre choice, I think I quite like that option, because if we go out on the super softs and hit the red, so we're going pushing, the engine's just going to explode. We need to be, we'll give them 12 laps because we don't want them to lap at the same point, so we'll give this one a little bit more fuel. So the objective to get our money is 16th or above. We know that we're expected to finish last, so to keep our job, we should be fine. But if we need money, which we do, if we can scrape one car in the top 16, that'd be fine. So this is the driving style to start the race. We're going to go with standard. If cars are going to overtake us, we're going to be near the back. But what we're hoping of is that bad shit happens further up the field. We can come in and smash it. So you're actually placed on the grid where opposite of where you are on the championship. There's no qualifying. So if you're bottom of the championship, you start first every race, which makes it quite interesting with the overtaking. But we're not worrying. So obviously, I think it's alphabetical probably or something at the moment. So we're starting 12th and or first. We know he's going to go backwards, okay? So don't worry about him getting overtaken. We cannot keep up with these cars. It's not a level playing field. So if we can just don't get in any trouble, don't crash. Just hold on. If you can actually look at everybody else. My face will be over it a bit, but you can sort of see it. Down the right-hand side there, everybody else is really pushing it. They're going for it. You know, starting off, I'm going to go for it, get some places up. Ours is, we're going for the longer play here. They're going to burn out their super soft tyres. They're going to have to come in quicker. They might even have to make an extra pit stop than we're going to. So that's our plan. So as you can see, 30-lap race. Any other information that I need to give? If you've got any questions and stuff, then ask in the comments below. So we've dropped to 11th and 16th. Fine. Even if we put super soft tyres on, and we said on here, strategy, go for it, overtake and attack, they've still got much better cars than us, so we're just wasting it. But you can see on the tyre wear gauges here, these guys on super softs, even these guys on softs, are burning out their tyres pretty quick. We're just Sunday drive, okay? That's our main thing. Let's just overtake. Eat my dust, Nick. Ha! Good. He's doing all right. Old Evans. Hanging on to 12th position. We're doing the long game here. This is the long game. Okay. Forgetting 12th. Okay, 13th. Hanging on to 13th. Okay, hanging on to 14th. Okay, hanging on to 15th. 16th. Okay, 6th. This is like fully to be expected. It took me a while to get my head around it, so somebody's pitting already. Interesting. So for one of the sponsors, one with 16th or above, we're out of that target. So the two people have pitted already because... Interesting, I don't know why they pitted. Okay, so this is the grip on the track. So the grip's getting higher and higher as rubber is put onto the track and you get warmer. Shit, is it about to piss down? It's going to rain. It is going to rain in about four laps time. So we can afford to push now because we're going to have to come in anyway. So we might as well use these tyres up, use some of this fuel up and maybe get some decent times. Because in a few laps time, we're going to have, the rain screws everything up. It's amazing. Look, at we're racing. I'm going to let him race. There's no team orders here, people. Race away. Although Santa Ana is the better driver. Okay, shit. Okay, so it's when you go in for intermediates. That's the question. It doesn't look like it's going to rain too much, but it's going to get pretty hairy pretty quickly. It looks like. We'll wait for the rain to start before we... We won't preempt it too much, but I think if we can be one of the earliest in... See, this is actually screwed over our plan. Our plan was to glide for another 6-7 laps. Whereas they've used all their tyres up, but we're all going to have to come in anyway. So it's not. This has not helped us. Rain does really screw with your plans. That's why it's often quite a good idea, which is probably what I should have done, which was to have each of your drivers on a different tactic. So one guy can do the long play, soft tyres, chugging along. The other guy can go for it a bit more, because then if one of you gets fucked over, then the other can sort of do all right. Okay, it's not raining yet. The longer everybody's pitting, see, the longer it cannot rain for, this is great, because they're pitting onto softs, and it's about to rain. Please rain. I want you to rain, because a lot of these guys are pitting. Like Evan's tyres are absolutely fudged. Should have kept an eye on that. Stop pushing, your tyres are murder. And you can stop pushing as well. We need to hold, we can't pit. There is no point pitting Evans, even though he desperately needs it. Right, conserve the tyres. Can we ask him to let her through if he's going to be allowed to make through? Right, because he's struggling, so there's no point in him holding her up. Right, they're coming back through. So he does need to pit, but we just need to hold on and hope it rains. Come on, rain. There's the rain. The rain's coming. The rain, you can see it on the screen. The rain is coming down. See, these people that haven't pitted yet are in great spot. Like, the question is how quickly we go in to get the sort of best window for intermediate tyres. I think we pit this guy straight away because he's dead. So intermediate tyres last for 11 to 13 laps in a perfect situation. Our car is shit, so it's usually less than that. But we've got 25 laps to go, so we could do one more stop after this. Maybe, and scrape it to the end. We'll see, because with the weather, we fucking knows. Right, we're going to put a bunch of fuel in, because I think it's going to stay wet. It doesn't look like it's going to rain for long, does it? What's that? Oh, the decisions. I don't think we need to go a massive amount of fuel, then. 8 laps. I think 8 laps is good. We don't need to repair any parts just yet. And you can do a more risky pit stop. I usually go for balanced. It's a little bit quicker than a safe one, but you've got more risk that something might go horribly wrong. Well, now the question what we do is with Santi Ana, it's not going to rain for very long, so if she can hang on. Her tires are pretty fucked anyway, so I think we go in. We give her one more lap, I think. Yeah, just gone through the pit lane, so we'll send her in after this lap. We might as well tell her to really go for it. We're going to pit her in. Now the question, my friends, this is where it gets fucking hairy. It's not far away from stopping raining. If we could you go like on the softs, survive the next sort of 3 laps of rain and then not have to change back to softs because you're already on them. I'm going to gamble, and the reason I'm going to gamble is not because I think it's a massive chance of this paying off, but because we're already going to be in and about the last place anyway, so why not gamble? I think these are the sort of things this team needs to do to try and get ahead, is a big gambly pit stop. We're going to fuel her right up because we're hoping it's going to be clear weather for the rest of the race, at least most of it. Balanced. Okay. God bless everyone. Okay, so she's coming in. We need you to push on your way out of the pit. If you go too slow, if you sort of conserve the tyres when your temperature of your tyres is really low, then it just won't get any grip. So you need to get a little bit of warmth into it. So when you come out of the pits, I generally at least go for push for a lap or two. Okay, Dreyfus has crashed. We've moved up a position, people. Hallelujah. We're basically the winners of the world at this point. Right, so Santa Ana is going to come in. Oh, on a safety car. Oh, is that bad? I'm not quite sure the safety car rules. Can we pit? We can pit, can't we? But we're going to lose. Oh, I'm so confused. Safety car for one lap because of that crash. Man, it's quite chucking it down now. This could be a mistake. No, it's going to be gorgeous sunshine. Look, I'm still gambling. So you're just going to have to take it very, very cautiously for the next two or three laps. Just take it easy, love. Keep your neutral medium. Just chug round. Survive. Right. We're coming out 15th spot. Where's the safety car? Right there. So there's the safety car at the top of the map there. We were just next to the one. So we're all gradually catch up with that safety car. So there's no point in burning your tyres out because you're trying to catch, you know, race. We've got a dilemma. She said, look, I need intermediates. We're going to say no. Just be really careful. Just really, really, really careful. Because look, it's going to get sunny. This is the wettest it'll ever be, okay? It's going to get good. I promise you, love. Right? Look, it's about to get sunny. The sun will come out in two laps. Bet your bottom dollar. Okay. So everybody's concertining up behind the safety car. We're that slow, we can't catch the safety car. Right. Whoever's 19th, who's chi? So looking at tyres, there's a few people on intermediates and quite a few people on soft. So I think we made the right decision taking this gamble. It's good to have, like I said, it's good to have your drivers on different strategies, just so if you make a mistake, you're both not screwed. We're going to have to come in with Evans relatively soon, I think, because there's no point in inducing it at the moment. I want to look at the cars in. Heading to the garage on the end of this lap, so he's almost got a full lap. Because I'm thinking we're going to be looking to go back onto softs. Probably the grip is still pretty low, going to be for low for a while. In two laps, we've got six laps of fuel, so we might as well use up the fuel and get some good lap times. Obviously, if you don't use the fuel, you can put less fuel in at the pit stop. But I think it's worth it just to get some decent lap times in. We'll go with like an orange, I think, a bit of high. We need to be very careful of our parts, so we don't want to push too much, regardless of what the strategy is, because we have the worst cars. They're made out of plastic. They're not good. Right, the cars are in. Oh, look, Evans with a super start there. Well, Evans is going to be on the better tyres right now. So we'll not give way. Let Evans go through because he's got intermediates. And right now, intermediates are a much better tyre for the next two laps at least. So Evans, get through. So he's racing against people on slicks here at the moment. So hopefully we'll jump to Evans. He's battling. He is battling. Don't crash. Don't crash. Okay. It stopped raining. It's lovely and sunny. It's going to dry up the track nice and quick. Santa Ana's times are going to drop, I think, to suggest it. Evans has got to make the most of this couple of laps, really. Right, we'll get him to push. William Evans is locked up. Damn it, I've flat spotted my tyre, screwed up when I pulled it. Okay, he lost a bit of tyre there. He's going to have to come in soon anyway, I think, for softs. Don't let him do you on the outside. He's done you on the outside, mate. Oh, so is he. Come on. Oh, and another one. Oh, that's a horrific corner. Right, neutral, because those tyres are down to 55%. Right, so... Sorry, yeah, that's fine. Don't worry about it, mate. The fact you're even battling with other cars is fantastic. Jesus Christ, there could be a crash here. Okay, right. I've yet to have a proper crash, which is good. Okay, so we're second and third from last. Oh, Jesus, they always crashed into each other. Let them race. Let them race. She's on nice. She's got plenty of tyres left. Better than all the other people on soft. So, oh, that's a lovely outbreak. No, not quite. Oh, she's gone through now, though. Oh, it's good racing. Don't crash into each other. Oh, my God, he's taking it back. He said he wants to prove that he's better than her, didn't he? So, fair play to him. He's going for it. It's when do we come in? It's nice and sunny. I think we come in soon. Maybe even this lap. I want to be one of the... How many laps we got left? 18 laps left. That's two more stints. That's fine. I think we come in now. I think we come in now. Right, pit stop. We want enough fuel to do half of this. At 19 laps, we'll do 10 laps here. Do we need to fix this fucking engine? I feel like... Look, 12 seconds pit stop. If I fix the gearbox, 15 seconds. Oh, it's a killer. It's an absolute killer. No, fuck it. Don't need a gearbox. Right. Their pace is very similar now, the two, the wets and the intermediates and the soft. So if you pit him now, she can go ahead, maybe get a couple of good laps in. We're hoping she only has to stop one more time. So I don't want to push. In fact, the 64% is not great. Might need to conserve. Can I start attacking? She wants to attack to get the tyre temperatures up more, but it's going to bloody just melt the tyres off. And we can't do a stint of 17 laps. Fuck it. We can always put on some super softs for like a little splash and dash at the end where we do like five laps on full bore. Right, so Santa Ana's in 16th place. 17th. 16th is the goal. We get 200 grand for 16th. Okay. We need somebody else. Like, two more cars to crash. Okay, so it's shifting into third. Feels clunky, guys. Just a heads up. So this is the condition of the... Yeah. Right, so we can... I'm going to push this a little bit. So she's overtaken a few people because they've pitted. But I think she's not going to be able to do one more stop. We're 53%. If she does one more and gets like 9 laps out. If we pitted on 15, get 9 laps out of it, that would be 25. And then we just go for a splash and dash, I think. Fresh super softs. Wring the neck out of the thing. We might have to fix the car anyway, so I don't know if it's going to matter. Matter a great deal, to be honest. I think we could be looking at a 18th, 19th finish here. But at least we battled. I'm trying to find the positives. Okay. Look, she's battling. Okay, she's lost the battle, but she did battle. Oh, wait. On the outside. Go on, girl. Still a fight. Didn't give it up easy. Like to see that. It's good. Hates dueling, so this is her personality trait. The pressure of one-on-one fights is too much for me. Brilliant. Like race driver, you mean? Yeah. And this guy has got action averse. He likes nice clear tracks. -2 overtaking. We haven't got the best drivers in the world, but hopefully they're... Some are permanent, some are temporary. Like, we're going to need to have to... We want to... Right, we keep her... This will be her last lap, I think. Don't push the tyres because like 36%, they're getting very dodgy. Don't want to turn the engine up either because that's just going to... So we've gained a few spots, but most of this is because of pits. Once we pit, we're going to be down with Evans, it's fair to say. Evans is now 15 seconds off 18th place. Okay, yeah, right. This could be a long old stop. So we're going to add fuel. We want to assume that this is going to be not half. We want to do over half. So we've got 15 laps remaining. So if we go 8 after, maybe even 9, because we're going to do a little splash and dash. So we'll go 9. We've got to fix this. Look at that. Might even need to fix the gearbox. 30, might as well. Then if you get points for finishing a race, so a 32-second pit stop in the offing, boys. His car's also falling apart. You don't get this at bigger teams, by the way. This is just a poor man's team issue. On my other game, where I'm the third worst team, I still get it a little bit, but don't have to. Once you get the reliability up, which we showed you earlier in the car design, it's not an issue. Okay, she's in the pits. She's going to drop all the way down, I'm assuming. Is Evans going to overtake her? Evans is going to overtake her.
Hooray! Laters.
Look at this. Look at this pit stop. 32 seconds. It's horrific. Right, so we've got 12 laps to go. She can do almost 10 on this fuel. But it's not going to be 10 because our car's shit, so it's going to be more like 8. Weather forecast, have we got any more rain? Okay, the grip's going to improve. Right, so he's just got to chug around now. We need to turn down his tyres a little bit. 54%. Once they get past 50%, you start seeing a little bit of a drop-off. You can look at all the like lap times and what people are doing here any point you want to. So I think the plan is Evans comes in 3 laps time or so, softs until the finish, last 8 laps, and then Santa Ana can come in maybe 5 laps, super softs for a little sprint finish for no apparent reason. I think they might be racing each other a lot this season. I can't see them actually really pushing anybody, to be honest. He's only 8 seconds behind the next position, so it's not horrific. We're about to be lapped, which is a little bit embarrassing, in a 30-lap race. On lap 19, it is a little bit embarrassing to be lapped. Ram him off. Ram him off, Evans. Whoa, Jesus. Okay, it's fine. Just make sure there's no... Always keep an eye on the rain, because this can change at any time. I've had it start pissing down and not even realise. There's moisture... Water on the track is going up in a couple of hours... In a couple of laps' time. What? Are we getting another shower? I can't see it. It'll be so close to the end of the race, I don't think it's going to matter. But it could matter for old Santa Ana. Because her stop will be perfect timing, maybe. Oh, my Lord. 10 laps, okay. Okay, you can come in. The car's falling apart. Okay, so we've got 10 laps left, so we have to fuel it. We'll give it, we can give it enough fuel. A little bit of excess fuel maybe, because we can burn it, because we're going to repair the engine anyway. Oh my fucking Lord, that is ridiculous. Let's just fix it all. 53 seconds. How on earth am I supposed to compete with 53 second pit stops? Right, I think it's safe to say Santa Ana is going to finish ahead this race. Come on, boys. Is the almighty pit stop, and Santa Ana now gets to wave as she goes, drives past. There it is. And he's through the pit stops for another 40 seconds. Personal best lap for Santa Ana. That's really good to see. That's what you've got to go for, these little mini victories. Her new personal best lap is very welcome. Remember, these are all young drivers and young race mechanics, so they're going to improve along with, you know, parts gradually. Oh my lord, that pit. He's been in the pit lane for 75 seconds. Cool, the car seems to... Yes, it is, mate, because we basically rebuilt it while you were sitting there. That's why. Right, so he's got excess fuel, so we can keep him on that strategy. She can do... I think we can up it a little bit, actually. We can go for a little bit more. See if we can get another best lap out of her. That'd be quite cool. So we're going to pit in about 2 laps time. What's the weather? I'm not seeing rain, but they're seeing water on the track. It's a very small amount. Could be the time thing. Bit of dew. I don't know what time it is. Clutching for straws here. At least Dreyfus crashed and we didn't finish last. I'd like another breakdown though, or two, towards the end of the race, please, so we can scrape 16th. That's the dream, okay? As you can see here, it shows how far off your target you are. So target 16th, so 46 seconds. Yeah, it's not ideal, is it? No. I like Santana, she's racing second place. Go on, girl! Okay, there's it. Enjoyed it, it was a good battle. Right, come on, get a decent lap in. Right, and do one more lap after this, I think. It's raining. It's not on the fucking forecast. Shit. It looks like it's ending to me a little bit. Bloody forecast. Why have they still not learned to do forecasting right? Right. Give it another lap, girl. And then you've got, like... You're going to have sort of 5 laps of sprinty stuff. Blue flag for William Evans. That means blue flag is because you're getting lapped and you have to get out of fucking way, you slag. How's she doing? 16 seconds behind 17th. 21 seconds behind the... Because they're pitting, aren't they? Behind 16th, which is our goal. This is... It's going to be a long old season, boys. We're going to get some new parts soon, though. We can afford to build 2 new parts. And then improve the reliability, which would be the big thing. That's the big thing we need to work on. Nice. This is a good lap from Santa Ana. Go on, girl. You know, the best lap, that'd be amazing. Boom! New personal best lap. She's flying. I'm loving this. I like to see this. Gives me hope for the future, this does. I'm going to pit this lap, though. And we're going to go on to some super softs. I don't think we're going to... What lap are we on? 25 of 30. So they're saying it's going to piss down again. Ah. Oh. This has not worked out well, has it? I think we're going to have to go softs, because super softs are just going to get destroyed in the water. Ah, oh, fudge it. YOLO, people. YOLO. Not too much. We've only got 6 laps left. She can hobble round if need be. Go. I wonder if anybody else needs to stop. Rogers might need to stop. See, somebody else went soup. If you're ever unsure of the tactic to go for, you can always watch other people's and react to what they do, like when they pit and what they go for. You can always do that as well. I just like doing my own thing. And I think with our little team, we've got to gamble and do weird shit to try and leapfrog like teams. Right, we're in. Coming in. This could be a mistake. But we've got at least another couple of laps. Yeah, it's only going to be 2 laps. It's not going to be worth it. So we had to come in. We couldn't put intermediates on. So the only options were soft or super soft. We might as well give these super softs a go. Okay, the car's broken again. 27%. It's fine. Don't look at it. Don't look at the flashing lights, love. Just drive around. Right, it'd be interesting to see if she can beat her lap time again. That'd be amazing. We're 18th place. We're 45 seconds off 16th. Well, I want to see a good lap. Next lap I want to see flying. Tyres are up to temperature. Track's pretty dry. It's a little bit damp, but it's fine. I want to see some magic. Go on, girl. Fly down this lap. Fly! How's old Evans doing? He's just chugging round. We'll just ignore his existence, I think. Lap 28. I thought somebody retired. I got excited. Has he got enough to last? He's got enough fuel. Yeah, he's got plenty of fuel. Let's burn it. Tyres for three laps. Yeah, it's fine. Come on, let's Santa Ana. New personal best sector. Nice. And it's raining again. This is the issue we had. I think there's no point doing anything. A pit stop could just take longer. We go to the end. Go on. Personal best time. That's got to be a personal best time, isn't it? I think it was. Two best sectors. I don't know if there's any way of seeing her laps over the course of a race, because that would be really nice. We're at 64% with two laps left. We probably need to just ease back off it, especially with this weather. Oh, somebody's got a car that's dead. He's in 12th place. I wonder if we can catch him. Oh, it's proper chucking it. He's retired. Come on, go. The retirees, I don't think, actually stop. They just go really slowly, which is bizarre. I'm not pitting you. You've got two laps left, love. This would be crazy. It'd be crazy if we pit you now. Just don't crash. Right. 1 second. Doorbell. Alright, we're back. Sorry about that. As the delivery. You know you've made it when you're getting food delivered. Right, here we go. Oh, the headphones! I've got quite a bit of fuel, that's fine. Okay, I don't want to turn up the engine mode because the whole thing's about to blow up. So, just get to the end, love. We've moved up to 17th place ahead of that retired car, which is good. Just need somebody else to crash on the final lap and we're right. It is proper pissing down now, though. Just take it easy. Just take it real easy. Yes, Evans. He's done it as well. Evans is through 17th and 18th. You could call that last, because we only beat crashed cars. And it probably is. But that's fine. The fact we didn't. Our cars didn't explode so far. The fact that our cars haven't exploded yet is definitely a good thing. I really shouldn't have spoken so soon. We've still got half a lap to go. Come on. Just get there. Don't explode. If we do catch on fire, at least it's raining to put it out. So, you know, there's always a silver lining. Right, coming up to this back straight now. Make it. Nurse it home, Santa Ana. Nurse it home. Okay. I thought she'd exploded. That's fine. Right, just get round. Get round. Chuck it round the corner. He's finished because he's lapped and shit. There we go. We really need to be doing better. I'm not sure what you expected to be better than this, love. You joined this team that hasn't got a car that works for an entire race, so I don't know what you expected exactly. Could have done better with the fuel. The rain did mess up our plans that we had for her at the beginning of the race, which was to go longer. You can see all the pit stops here now. So most people made 3 pit stops. We made 3 pit stops. But just our whole plan, we wanted to go 10, 11, 12 laps with this first stint to make it a 2-stop strategy. I think that might be one of our best routes in to picking up some points, is to maybe do a different strategy. But So this is the checking cars. So if you've got any risks of rule breaks that we showed you in the car design, this is where you can get screwed over. We're not risking anything. We'll look down the bottom. There you go. 3 points and 4 points, people. We're off the mark in the... there we go. In the championship. Let's have a look at the drivers' championship. This is where his thing was expecting us to finish bottom. This is it here. So, yeah. Yeah. On target, boys. Get in. Right, guys. There you go. We'll finish the episode there. Hope you did enjoy it. I love it. It's really, really enjoyable. What we'll do for the future is basically cut out a lot of the crap. I just wanted to go through that for you so you can sort of see the inner workings a bit. But let me know exactly what you want to see. I was thinking of just sort of explaining how practice went and how what parts we've got for this race and then just doing the race. If you want to see other stuff, just do let me know. Please do like this comment. Obviously, it's something a bit different from my channel, but I do plan to continue this save throughout the series and maybe even do another season after that. And subscribe if you're new to the place, and I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.